It's something you look forward to your entire time at UMR. I mean, up into field camp, all you talk about is when you go to field camp. And then when you get there, you find out what all the talk's about.
Just know, you are looking at one of the most spectacular and probably most important outcrops in Western North America.
It's so exciting to be out there every day hiking and seeing new things, taking samples up close and far away, and just being out there with the geology, with the rocks.
Utah's not as flat as expected.
Yeah. They're like, climb the ridge.
We've done a lot more climbing than I thought we would. We're still alive.
Looks good. You want Steve to tell you about it? They should know all about it.
This is a lahar. It's a volcanic ash and mud.
Dinosaur footprint.
Three-toed.
Dinosaur footprint?
It's probably, since it's three-toed, what?
It's a carnivore of some sort, but I don't.
Every day traveling to a new place, doing a cross-section at 55 miles an hour in the van.
Elevation 6,000, mile 9.5.
Just driving and taking notes so when you get back to your room, you can make your cross-section.
Put the colorful lamp up, you know, the one with color on it.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. I mean,
it takes some work, but it's fun. I mean, we see some of the most amazing stuff, for a geologist at least.
A week of camping was fantastic, spending time in Arizona in the Grand Canyon. It was just incredible. It was a smallish department, so you got to know a lot of people in your class. You got to know your instructors very well. It seemed like a very kind of an intimate relationship with your instructors and with the other people in your class. You just got to know so much about geology.
I learned so much out here. It's unbelievable.
You can't sometimes tell if the change is due to faulting or just due to a big, now I'm going into an old valley, then up an old mountain, then down into another old valley.
And at the end, you have all your notes and all your papers, and you put them together and make this incredible paper of what you think happened and why Bryce Canyon is there, and what happened at the Grand Canyon, and it's overwhelming, the things you learn out there.